We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello dear students, myself Dr. Damayanti Chibadka, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department from S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Umrak, Babin, having Institute Code 049. Today we are going to discuss about Special Concrete Part 3 from your ME GTU syllabus of Construction Engineering and Management Branch, Advanced Concrete Technology, having subject code 3721417. A special concrete is there, so many concrete we have discussed, and today we will discuss another topics in under special concrete. Today in a special concretes we will discuss high volume fly ash concrete and high strength concrete. In our previous lectures we have introduced and we have gone through lightweight concrete, high density and radiation shielding concrete, roller compacted concrete, fiber reinforced concrete and self compacting concrete. If I will give you some little glimpse about that, then we have studied in lightweight concrete where we don't want any strength aspects mainly, but we want to reduce the weight of our structure, then we are using lightweight concrete. Such type of discussions and things we discussed in lightweight concrete. In high density radiation shielding concrete, where nuclear power plant or any important structure is there, so in that case if we are using that type of concrete, and regarding that we have discussed in detail. In roller compacted concrete, so we discussed dam, road, where we are using rollers to compact concrete, that type of things we discussed in roller compacted concrete with useful technical data. In a fiber reinforced concrete we discussed about many type of fiber which we use in concrete as per its applications for our advantageous special concrete. In self compacting concrete we have seen that the concrete having ability to compact it by its own weight, and in that we discussed many things. So we can say that we already discussed lightweight concrete, high density and radiation shielding concrete, roller compacted concrete, fiber reinforced concrete and self compacting concrete. So today we will focus on high volume fly ash concrete and high strength concrete. From the name itself you can understand there is a high content of fly ash in concrete, okay. And high strength concrete, you can understand the strength of concrete will be higher compared to nominal concrete. But we will go in detail as a technical as per your syllabus and exam point of view. So for better understanding of high volume fly ash concrete, in India the generation of fly ash is going to have a quantum jump in the coming decade. It is tentatively estimated that currently 2000 AD as per the book data we produce about 100 million tons of fly ash, and out of which only about 5% is utilized in making blended cement and in a few cases as mineral admixtures. The disposal of remaining fly ash has become a serious problem, right? So there will also be greater need to economize and conserve the cement for more than one reasons. So one of the practical method for conserving and economizing cement and also to reduce the disposal problem of a fly ash is to popularize the high volume fly ash concrete system. High volume fly ash concrete is a concrete wherein 50 to 60% fly ash is incorporated. to prepare or to produce or to manufacture concrete. It was first developed for mass concrete application where low heat hot vibration was of primary consideration. Subsequent work has demonstrated that these type of concrete showed excellent mechanical and durability properties required for structural applications and pavement construction. If we'll discuss more about HVFA concrete, then some investigation have also shown the potential use of high volume fly ash system for shotcreting, lightweight concrete and roller compacted concrete. In Canada, considerable work is going on the development of blended cement incorporating high volume fly ash. Nowadays, in many countries, people are working in this area, HVFA concrete. The use of this type of cement permits to overcome the problem of additional quality control and storage facilities at the ready mixed concrete batching plants. Due to very low water cement of high volume fly ash concrete, the use of plasticizer become necessary for obtaining workable concrete to work at different places for different applications. Use of air entwining admixtures is also currently used in this practice. If we'll talk about high volume fly ash concrete, then most of investigation on high volume fly ash concrete were carried out at Canada Center for Mineral and Energy Technology, it is called as CanMet, CanMet. The typical mix proportion used and optimized on the basis of investigations as shown in that table. As per the data, water quantity, then ASTM type cement quantity, class F fly ash quantity, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, air entraining admixture, super plasticizer, all these ingredients quantity is given as per the strength. So there is three strength is mentioned: low strength, medium strength, high strength. So as per the investigation, the typical mix proportion used and optimized on the basis of investigation. So if water quantity, cement, fly ash, if water will be 115 kg per meter cube, cement contain ASTM type 1 cement contain 125 kg per meter cube, class F fly ash contained is 165 kg per meter cube, coarse aggregate contained and fine aggregate contained 1170 kg per meter cube and 800 kg per meter cube respectively. Air entraining admixture and super plasticizers are 200 ml per meter cube and 3 liter per meter cube respectively. So as per that data, means for this ingredient, this quantity will responsible for low strength of concrete. If water quantity will be 120 kg per meter cube, ASTM type 1 cement contained 155 kg per meter cube, class F fly ash will be 215 kg per meter cube, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate will be 1195 kg per meter cube and 645 kg per meter cube respectively, and air entraining admixture and super plasticizers 200 ml per meter cube and 4.5 liter per meter cube respectively, then the strength will be medium strength. Same way, if water will be 110 kg per meter cube, ASTM means American Society of Testing Material type 1 cement that contained is 180 kg per meter cube, class F fly ash 220 kg per meter cube, coarse aggregate and fine aggregate 1110 kg per meter cube and 760 kg per meter cube respectively, and air entering admixture and super plasticizer 280 ml per meter cube and 5.5 liter per meter cube respectively, then the strength of that concrete will be high strength. So all these data are based on the investigations. It is clearly mentioned over here, so don't get confused that how these strength and values come, because all the data are come from investigation. If we'll talk about the properties of high volume fly ash concrete, then for fresh concrete which prepared from high volume fly ash, then the properties are, most of the investigations at Carmet have been performed with flowing concrete, means concrete with a slump of about 180 to 220 mm. Dosage of super plasticizer may vary considerably. They have also used zero slump concrete without super plasticizer for roller compacted concrete applications. If we'll talk about bleeding and setting time, then as the water content is low in high volume fly ash, the bleeding is very low and often we can say it's a negligible. Setting time is little longer than that of conventional concrete. This is because of low cement content, low rate of reaction and high content of super plasticizer. One will have to be careful in cold weather concreting in stripping the formwork. If we'll talk about the heat of hydration, then on account of low cement content, the heat of hydration generated is rather low. Carmet investigations have shown that the heat of hydration of a high volume fly ash concrete was about 15 to 25 centigrade less than that of reference concrete without fly ash. In one of the experiments, in case of a concrete block of size 3.05 into 3.05 into 3.05 meter, the maximum temperature reached was 54 degrees centigrade, increase of 35 degrees centigrade, as against a heat of hydration of 83 degrees centigrade, increases of 65 degrees centigrade in a block of same size made out of concrete using ASTM type 1 cement only. In both the cases, the weight of cementitious material used is same. If we'll talk about the curing, so we know about the normal concrete curing. Okay, so in HVFA concrete is there, then curing of that type of concrete in high volume fly ash concrete is to be cured effectively and for longer duration than ordinary concrete, or we can say conventional or normal concrete, means concrete containing cement only. And also normal fly ash concrete to obtain continued pozzolanic reaction so that high volume fly ash develops desirable mechanical properties. Please focus over here again. High volume fly ash concrete is to be cured effectively and for longer duration than ordinary concrete and also normal fly ash concrete to obtain continued pozzolanic reaction so that HVFA develops desirable mechanical properties. High volume fly ash concrete should be properly protected from premature drying by properly covering the surface. That we should take care while making high volume fly ash concrete. If we talk about the mechanical properties of high volume fly ash concrete, then the properties of high volume fly ash concrete are largely dependent on characteristic of cement and fly ash. Fly ash having many classes, that's why here mentioned that it depends on characteristic of cement and fly ash. Generally, the mechanical properties are good in a view of lower water content, lower water to cementitious ratio and dense microstructure. The typical mechanical properties of high volume fly ash concrete as per Carmet investigation is given in table in next slide. So if we'll talk about the Carmet guideline about the strength, then here compressive strength is given for different ages, flexural strength is given for different ages, splitting tensile strength is given for 28 day, then Young modulus of elasticity is here mentioned for different ages. So if we'll talk about compressive strength, then 1 day strength of HVFA concrete is 8 and plus or minus 2 megapascal. At 7 days the strength will be 20 plus or minus 4 megapascal. At 28 days, compressive strength will be 35 plus or minus 5 megapascal. At 91 days, the strength will be 43 plus or minus 5 megapascal. And if we'll talk about compressive strength at 365 days, then it will be 55 plus or minus 5 megapascal. When we'll talk about the flexural strength, then on 14 days, it will be 4.5 plus or minus 0.5 megapascal. And if we'll talk about at 91 days, the flexural strength of high volume fly ash concrete is 6 plus or minus 0.5 megapascal. If we'll talk about the splitting tensile strength at 28 days for high volume fly ash concrete, then it will be 3.5 plus or minus 0.5 megapascal. Here, if we'll talk about the Young's modulus of elasticity, then at 28 days it will be 35 plus or minus 2 gigapascal. At 91 days it will be 38 plus or minus 2 gigapascal. And a drying shrinkage strain at 448 days is 500 plus or minus 50 into 10 raised to minus 6. Specific creep strain at 365 days per megapascal of stress is 28 plus or minus 4 into 10 raised to minus 6. So as per the investigation, different type of strength and Young's modulus of elasticity is mentioned in that table for high volume fly ash concrete. Durability is also main point of concrete whenever any concrete is there. So no doubt strength is very important, but for lifelong use or for long performance, we have to check durability too. So if we talk about the durability of HVFA concrete, then several laboratory and field investigation conducted in Canada and USA, as well many countries are working for durability of high volume fly ash in concrete. And nowadays, even our in India, many researchers are working in high volume fly ash concrete field. So several laboratory and field investigation conducted in Canada and USA have demonstrated excellent durability of high volume fly ash concrete. It was tested for water permeability, resistance to freezing and thawing, resistance to the penetration of chloride ions, corrosion to steel reinforcement, resistance to sulfate attack, controlling alkali aggregate expansion, carbonation, and durability in marine environment. This durability check is compulsory for performance, so many researchers are working in this area still. The results have shown superior quality of high volume fly ash concrete. And based on the investigation and the study of that high volume fly ash concrete for different properties, there are many advantages derived from the test. So these advantages are adequate structural strength, improved flexural and tensile strength, result in less bleeding, cohesive flowable concrete, improves resistance to sulfate and other chemicals, gives a superior appearance, cost is less, and environmentally sound. No doubt there are few disadvantages of high volume fly ash concrete. So disadvantages are listed over here. All fly ashes cannot be used in structural concrete. As I told you, there are many classes for fly ash. So all fly ashes can't be used in structural concrete. Replacement level depends on fly ash properties based on its type. Requires a good knowledge of mix proportioning. Your concrete mix design part should be strong for that mix proportioning. We will discuss about mix design also in our upcoming lectures. So that thing is also important to do any mix design in concrete. So here in HVFA concrete requires a good knowledge of mix proportioning. It comes from the trial and by using different methods. If not handled properly, may be dangerous. Requires better quality control at site. Slow rate of hardening and hence behaves differently to steam curing. requires good curing for minimum 7 days. Its surface should be cured properly. Now, if we'll talk about the use of high volume fly ash concrete, then all among conventional fly ash concrete has been in use in many parts of the world for several decades. Various standards and codes have generally limited the addition of class F fly ash to 10-25%. Laboratory and field demonstration projects during last 10-12 years have shown that concrete containing 55-60% fly ash has excellent structural and durability characteristics when mixed with low water to cement ratio and super plasticizer. Since 1985, yet another new economical, useful construction material, high volume fly ash, has appeared on the construction scenario. Since then, this high volume fly ash has been used in many high-rise buildings, industrial structures, waterfront structures, concrete roads, and also in roller compacted concrete dams. There is high potential for this material on account of sound economy and usefulness to absorb large quantity of underutilized, otherwise harmful waste material. High volume fly ash concrete is defined as concrete with following attributes by its application, its use, its advantage. So, fly ash replacing cement by 30-60%, water binder ratio less than 0.40%, very low water, chloride and oxygen penetrability, almost double design life with least maintenance, means cost is reduced, better fresh concrete properties, better finishes, hence look is good, does not affect the schedule of construction, which is the salient feature of this concrete. Economical than conventional concrete and offers sustainability of depleting resources. Now, if we will talk about the high strength concrete, so we can say that compared to normal concrete, strength of this concrete will be high. So we will go with some technical content and technical data. So concrete is defined as high strength concrete solely on the basis of its compressive strength measured at a given age. Concrete is generally classified as normal strength concrete, high strength concrete and ultra high strength concrete. That normal strength concrete, it is abbreviated as a NSC, high strength concrete is capital H, capital S, capital C, HSC, and ultra high strength concrete is UHSC. There are no clear cut boundaries for these concretes for the above classification. In the 1970s, any concrete mixture that showed 40 MPa of strength or more compressive strength at 28 days were designed as high strength concrete. Please focus over here. Any concrete mixture that shows 40 MPa strength or more compressive strength at 28 days were designed as high strength concrete in 1970s. But nowadays, scenario is totally changed because advanced special concretes are in field. So later, 60-100 MPa concrete mixtures were commercially developed and used in the construction of high-rise building and long-span bridge in many parts of world. High strength are made possible by reducing porosity, inhomogeneity and micro cracks in the hydrated cement paste and the transition zone, which we can see from scanning electron microscope, ACM analysis of concrete cube. The utilization of fine pozzolanic material in a high strength concrete leads to a reduction of the size of crystalline compounds, particularly calcium hydroxide. Consequently, there is a reduction of the thickness of the interfacial transition zone in a high strength concrete, which we can observe in ACM analysis. The densification of the interfacial transition zone allows for efficient load transfer between the cement mortar and the coarse aggregate, contributing the strength of the concrete. If we talk about the high strength concrete, then no doubt cement, aggregate, water admixtures are there. But if we talk about the cement, then almost any Portland cement type can be used to obtain concrete with adequate rheology and with compressive strength up to 60 MPa. If we talk about aggregate, then in high strength concrete, the aggregate plays an important role on the strength of concrete. So, the low water to cement ratio used in high strength concrete causes densification in both the matrix and interfacial transition zone, and the aggregate may become the weak link in the development of the mechanical strength in high strength concrete. Ready mix concrete has taken its root in India nowadays, that we all know well. The manufacture of high strength concrete will grow to find its due place in concrete construction for all the obvious benefits. In the modern batching plants, high strength concrete is produced in a mechanical manner, of course. One has to take care about mix proportioning, shape of aggregate, use of supplementary cementitious materials, silica fume and superplasticizers. With the modern equipment and understanding of the role of materials, production of high strength concrete has become routine matter nowadays in concrete manufacturing field. There are special methods of making high strength concrete, which is listed over here, and we will discuss this too. The methods are seeding, revibration, high speed slurry mixing, use of admixture, inhabitation of crack, sulfur impregnation, use of cementitious aggregate. So as per that list, first we will talk about seeding. So please focus over here, because this involves adding a small percentage of finely ground, fully hydrated Portland cement to the fresh concrete mix. The mechanism by which this is supposed to aid strength development is difficult to explain. This method may not hold much promise. If we'll talk about the revibration, then concrete undergoes plastic shrinkage. Mixing water creates continuous capillary channels, bleeding, and water accumulate at some selected places. All these reduce the strength of concrete. Controlled revibration removes all these defects and increase the strength of concrete. If we'll talk about high speed slurry mixing, then these processes involve the advanced preparation of cement water mixture, which is then blended with aggregate to produce concrete. Higher compressive strength obtained is attributed to more efficient hydration of cement particles and water achieved in the vigorous blending of cement paste. If we'll talk about use of admixture, then it's a high strength concrete. So definitely our target to reduce water, and to reduce water we will use that type of admixture which are helpful to increase strength. Okay, so use of water reducing agent are known to produce increased compressive strength. Inhabitation of cracks. So concrete fail by formation and propagation of crack. If the propagation of crack is inhibited, the strength will be higher. This is what obvious. Replacement of 2-3% of fine aggregate by polyethylene or polystyrene, which called lenticules. 0.025 mm thick and 3 to 4 mm in diameter results in higher strength. They appear to act as crack arresters without necessitating extra water for workability. Concrete cubes made in this way have yielded strength up to 105 MPa. If we'll talk about sulfur impregnation, the satisfactory high strength concrete have been produced by impregnating low strength porous concrete by sulfur. The process consists of moist curing the fresh concrete specimen for 24 hours, drying them at 120 degrees centigrade for 24 hours, immersing the specimen in molten sulfur under vacuum for 2 hours, and then releasing the vacuum and soaking them for the additional half hour for further infiltration of sulfur. The sulfur infiltrated concrete has given strength up to 58 MPa. In that, use of cementitious aggregates are playing very important role. It has been found that use of cementitious aggregates has yielded high strength. The cement fondo is a kind of clinker having a very good strength. This glassy clinker, when finely ground, result in a kind of cement. When coarsely crushed, it makes a kind of aggregate known as alug. Using alug as aggregate, strength up to 125 MPa has been obtained with water cement ratio 0.32. Okay, so means we can say that low water cement ratio, high strength, but using different type of good aggregate or admixture or super plasticizer to produce high strength concrete. Advantage of high strength concrete are: high strength concrete resist loads that cannot be resisted by normal concrete, or we can say our conventional traditional concrete. It also increases the strength per unit cost, per unit weight, and per unit volume as well. These concrete mixes have an increased modulus of elasticity. If we'll talk about this advantage, that increased quality control is needed in order to maintain the spatial properties desired. High quality material must be used, minimum cover over reinforcement or minimum thickness of members may restrict the realization of maximum benefit. Available pre-stressed force in a member may be inadequate to achieve maximum strength. If we'll talk about high strength concrete's applications, then high strength concrete is required in engineering projects that have concrete component that must resist high compressive load. High strength concrete is used in the erection of high-rise structure. It has been used in components such as column, shear wall, and foundation. Means it's taking extra load. Okay, the building load is mainly depends on that element, structural elements. High strength are also occasionally used in bridge application, highway bridges as well. High strength concrete permit reinforced or pre-strained concrete girder to span greater length than normal strength concrete girder. So dear students, today we talk about high strength concrete and high volume fly ash concrete. So whatever I want to discuss with you regarding this concrete, as per your syllabus and as per your exam point of view, everything I mention clear in PPT by writing the things. Same thing I dictated to understand you well. So I hope from this content you will understand the special type of concrete in a high volume fly ash concrete and in a high strength concrete. From your final and semester previous exams, you can see that question asked from that special concrete portion, and you have to mention special type of concrete. So from these both the special concrete you can easily understand and you can easily write in your exams. Today our topic is complete over here. In my next lecture I will come with new topics. Till that, study well, stay safe, take care, and all the very best.